Good afternoon, viewers, and welcome to the first round of the FA Cup in Lagos State, Nigeria. The opening fixture between Cliquesports Academy and Buruj FC at the Agege Stadium, Lagos. My name is Movich. Today we shall be witnessing an encounter between two top academies in Nigeria competing at the FA Cup for progression to the round of 16. Cliquesports in all in red, traditional kit, and Buruj FC in lemon shorts and shirt with black socks. The center referee today is Mr. Samuel. The assistants are Mrs. Jane, Mr. Bademossi, and the fourth official, Mr. Ekene. This is an early afternoon kickoff, and it's built to be a top encounter between these two great academies who have a rich history of producing top players at the top flight level for the country. The players huddle together to say their prayers, but when the game starts, it's not going to be about prayers, it's going to be about performance. I'm co-commanding today. I'm live at the stadium at the Agege. Incidentally, this stadium was built in 1968 after the Civil War. It was upgraded to a synthetic pitch at the year 2000 and plays home to a lot of league matches at the professional level for Buruj Boys FC. And it's a very, very big venue for the FA Cup. Cliquesports Academy have produced international players for the country for under 17 and under 20 level. The likes of Kabir Akinshola and Adafi Egbedi. And incidentally, I have a 15-year-old in your ranks, AJ Stevens. He's been billed as the next big thing, what we shall see. So Cliquesports Academy are playing the traditional 4-3-3, and they kick off starting from right to left. And you stand the game in the front foot, AJ Steven. Throwing to Buruj Academy. We have two balls on the pitch. Buruj Academy is founded in the year 2004 and have been at the mainstay of academy football over the years. The pitch is a little bit wet from the rain. Cliquesports have a chance here from Sonny Matthew, hits a shot. Oh, early danger for Buruj Academy. It's Cliquesports play. I put Sonny in the screw from the early minute. Quick throw by Arnold Isaac. Cliquesports trying to build up from the right. Across it. Oh, offside for the Cliquesports striker, Francis Clare. The Agege Stadium is situated beside the ever-busy Murid Talal Muhammad International Airport in Lagos. So there is a lot of airline traffic around this area. Cliquesports attack through Kenechiku. He makes a good cross. Oh, good catch by the goalkeeper. Good catch by the goalkeeper. Cliquesports are showing a lot of early signs to want to attack. They're setting the tone for the game. It's going to be end-to-end stuff, I believe. Izuchi Obodo. Press it in. For Stibbe. Oh, tries to cross. Goalkeeper for Buruj Academy, Adamo, is trying to get his players into order. He has received a lot of shots early in the game. Corner kick to be taken by Arno Isaac, right back for Cliquesports Academy. Takes it in. Arrives in the box. Oh my word! Great chance for Cliquesports Academy by the striker, Francis Klan. He's taken three shots already in the space of 5 minutes. You fancy him behind the goal at this rate, don't you? The number 9, Francis Clem. Okay, Buruj on the ball now. Sherif. He's trying to dribble out. A little tussle on the ball. Buruj on the ball now. With your number 8, Ebuka. He passes forward. And he loses possession. Now there's a transition play. Isaac moves forward, passes the ball. They're just conceding possession. Both teams have found it difficult to retain a spell of possession, and it's just been clumsy at the least. But Buruj have the ball now. Good pass. Kenechiko for Cliquesports. Hey, nutmegs it. Cliquesports have something building up here. Kenechiko on the far side on the left. He tries to cross. Blocked. The keeper makes a good save. I would say Cliquesports are using the full width of the field. The full backs are getting forward a little. Something Buruj should be wary of. Izuchi Obodo. The captain, Adams, kicks it into touch. It's a throw-in. The winners of this tie will be playing the defending champion, COD United, at the next match day. So, COD United are the defending champions of the FA Cup and second in the league for promotion to the Premier League. Cliquesports break now with Wasiu. He tries to go forward. Pass to cross in, and the keeper collects it calmly. The FA Cup in Lagos State and all states in the Federation is the only tournament that pitches academy against professional teams, and it's always very interesting to see how they fare. A lot of upsets over the years. Oh, quick one for Cliquesports! Oh no! Keeper collects again. The Buruj goalkeeper has been fantastic. His name is Femi. Cliquesports have a shot at the goal. Oh, another chance gone. The captain have made an overlapping run. The captain for Cliquesports Academy, Adams. A weak shot out there. The goalkeeper for Buruj Academy, Femi, has been called into action for so many times in this opening minute. It's the busier. We haven't actually seen the goalkeeper for Cliquesports Academy. And they have the ball again. Cliquesports through Izuchi Obodo. Down to the left side for Kenechiku. Tries to dribble. And they still keep the ball. Babatunde Yusu. Izuchi Obodo. He shuffles. He takes his man out. Makes a cross. Easily cleared. And they have the ball again. Cliquesports on the ball. It's a draw. I think Cliquesports Academy sprung out of the block in this game. They're really on the toes, trying to get a goal, trying to get the ball behind the defense of Buruj Academy. It's just not clicking at the moment. Buruj is just hanging in there. They've hardly had a shot at the whole game. It's a free kick against Eze Steven, the 15-year-old Cliquesports midfielder. The foul was committed by Onobu. It's going to be taken by Francis Clem. Takes it in. Wasted it. It's poor. It's a poor free kick. It's a poor delivery by the young striker. The FA Cup is a historic competition in Lagos State and all states of the Federation. But incidentally, it's not being won by academies. Elite academies at this level compete with professional clubs and try to stake a claim for the top prize. But clumsy play by the Cliquesports defense, and now Buruj have a chance of your own. It's clumsy. Oh my. Against the run of play, they almost put your noses in front with a goal. Cliquesports playing up the back now. Izuchi. Is A. Steven. Battling now. Sonny Matthew. A true pass. Goes for Wasu. He rounds the goalkeeper. Finishes. Oh my. How did he miss that? Good interplay from Sonny Matthew to play Wasu Hamzat in. He rounded the goalkeeper finally. Just couldn't find his angle. Buruj hanging on. 0-0. The foul there on Sonny Matthew by okay. Can I check out? And it's go! Oh my! Another top save for the goalkeeper for Buruj Academy, Femi. He's really, really on top of his game today. He's the only player keeping Buruj Academy in the game right now. And it's been frantic end-to-end stuff. This is shaping up to be an epic. Corner kick, taken by Francis Clapp. It's a high one. Oh, Godwin is on the ball. It's in again. Buruj trying to clear their lines. The ball is still in the danger area. Okay, they clear it now. Arno Isaac. The clearance in. And it's a chance. And the keeper collects it. Good pressing from the Cliquesports player on the fullback for Buruj Academy. Michael for Buruj Academy, 17-year-old fullback. He wants to throw the ball now. The referee's actually go back a little. Buruj Academy don't seem to know how to hold possession. The Cliquesports attack through Sonny Matthews on the ball. He passes out wide to Isaac, and there's a chance again. Oh, for Isaac Steven, he fouled. He fell in the box. Play on, says the referee. And here come Cliquesports again. And Buruj have intercepted. Imagine that you should be an enforcer. He's just making sure the Buruj attack doesn't take steam, and it's really been frustrating for the Buruj midfielders. They've been unable to keep a rhythm going. Thank you. the goalkeeper for Cliquesports Academy, Dejo, has played for Nigeria at the junior level under 20 in 2011. The top goalkeeper has also had his degree in Canada. He's back in the academy trying to forge a professional career after his university degree. He has a wealth of experience having played at the international level. Won the bronze medal for his exploits. So, Cliquesports Academy will have confidence that they have a goalkeeper with pedigree. But oh my, we haven't seen that in action. AZ on the ball. A lot of empty seats at the far end of the stadium. On the common area behind me here, we have full seats. This is where most of the fans are. It's an early kickoff. Isaac plays one in. Good clearance for Buruj Academy. And the beauty attack again from the right. Cliquesports Academy. We Hamza Rasiu. He makes a low cross in. It's a chance! Oh, good shot by Isaac Steven. Couldn't find the net. Isaac Steven has been the revelation for Cliquesports Academy. Shows that they believe in youth during the academy and keep exposing its young kids to such a competition at an early age. Something that should be emulated. The national team selectors should be here to watch this. And here I go, Cliquesports again. Rising. That's the dribble in. Loses out. Izuchi Obodo. Turns. Passes. And Buruj recovered the ball. Through the attacker, Deba. Again, they can't find the rhythm. Buruj Academy. Cliquesports again for Isaac. Next support. He drops a pen pass. He's trying to play. He's super easy. Oh, good clearance. And it's in. Wasim Hamza. He crosses the ball. It's a chance. And the goalkeeper collects it. I would say the goalkeeper for Buruj Academy, Femi, has been exceptional. He has been the difference so far. This game could have been 2-3 goals up right now. It has been the difference. Well, it's the first booking of the game. The first booking of the game goes to Buruj Academy. Get number four. Innocent. Ball on Clem Francis, the Cliquesports striker. The free kick is about to be taken. He's got a set yellow. Taken by no one else. Isaac, the right back for Cliquesports Academy. He has been taking all the kicks and the corner kicks. Good try though. Kicks the ball in and Hamza Rasiu tries to go for a diving ender, but he misses his spot and the ball is out of play. Buruj Academy. Or the attack now. Aminu on the ball. Loses out to Captain Adams. For Cliquesports Academy. AJ Steven. 6-1. Here's a good pass in. For Clem Francis. They couldn't get the ball from the side of life. Wow, Ezuchi Ogodo. And then you can have a good breaking. Long one in, and it's out of play. It's not been a lot of coordination from the Buruj players. They've not been able to fashion out more chances from the other ones created. They need to do a lot more stick in this match. Cliquesports on the match again. Sonny Mati, Enetchukwu Fidelis, a long ball out, Tuano Isaac, the fullback, is off form, he makes a long cross in, oh, and he missed that! That was a golden chance, he was unmarked in the area, he had his eyes on the ball, but he took his eyes off at the key moment and missed the shot, that would have been 1-0. Cliquesports Academy again forming another creative chance but not converting. This has been the story of the game so far. Right back. Loses the ball. Oh, we have Stephen Ace on the ball. Beautiful touch. Ball just pulls out of play. It's a throw to Buruj Academy. And they have to find a chance of their own. And again, they've conceded possession. It's a throw to Cliquesports now. Banana by the defender Godwin. Steven Ezzy loses possession. And at the break forward now. Cliquesports Academy on the move with Isaac on the far end. Tries to dribble his man. Makes a pass to Steven Ezzy. He moves in. He loses out. Fast to dribble, start to do it too much. And they have the ball again, Cliquesports Academy, to Ezuchi Ogodo, to Isaac, to Hamza Kwasiu, to Babatunde Yusu. They pass the ball to the side, to Kenechukwu. Who beat this man, pass the ball inward, and a shot! Blocked by the Buruj defense, and they clear. And the striker for Buruj Academy, Odibo trying to close down the defender. Ball is over the line for scoring. It has to be said, Buruj Academy are trying to create their own chances in this game. The Cliquesports attack has been better, but they've not converted any of their chances so far. It's still 0-0 after 20 minutes. At the Agenge Stadium. I think you picked a knock there, Isaac. Official count, 3,105 people in this stadium right now. It's an early morning kickoff, and it's just the early rounds of the FA Cup, so empty seats expected to the latter round. I think the game just needs a goal. And it was fucked for life. But for now, Buruj with the throw. Ezuchi on the ball. Okay, that's a good move! It was a foul by the right fullback. Kenneth Osai for Buruj Academy. Foul on Kenechukwu. I thought he had the ball, but the referee
from my angle, I thought he had the ball. But the referee's on the pitch, he would have had a good angle to see it. It's a free kick, it's in. Good clearance by both defenders. And they win themselves a free kick. Buruj Academy trying to fashion a new attack here. The right back is overlapping, Osai. Makes a decoy pass in, the striker is there, oh! And he missed, oh my! That was good play by Buruj from the right hand flank, and they could have gotten the goal there. Had the striker, Aminu, not flopped his line. Oh, Cliquesports on the other end. Trying to move the attack now. The Hamza Kwasiu. They lose it up. And here comes Buruj again. Making from the right. Easily dealt with by the Cliquesports defense. And the clearance by the jaw goalkeeper. And now there's a chance here. Oh, offside. On Sonny Matthew. He was on goal. But he was offside. Good call by the Lions man. You see the coach of Cliquesports Academy on the touchline, backing orders to his lads. Cliquesports Academy attacking through Izuchi Obodo now. The referee gets in the way, but play on! And the advantage now to Buruj Academy as they have the ball, trying to play out of the back. Good turn by the number 4. And Cliquesports attacking through Hamza Wasiu, and he is in foul. Actually, Sonny Matthew on the right hand side. Free kick to be taken by Isaac. And it's a chance, and it's laid off, and it's a shot! Goal! It's a goal! By the striker Francis Clare for Cliquesports Academy, and they have the lead. A good free kick, a good cushion down by Sonny Matthew, and a left footed strike by the striker. That's what the game needs. It's a goal that has been coming, it's been in the pipe. We've seen it coming for a while right now, because there's been a relentless pressure on the defense of Buruj Academy, and finally the pressure has paid off for Cliquesports, and they have the lead. We need a response from Buruj Academy. And here they come. Innocent on the ball. He loses it out. Babatunde Yusuf, Izuchi Obodo. Good footwork and excellent dribble skills from this player. Plays forward. Francis Clam, the goal scorer, is on the ball. Makes a decoy pass and it's another chance! And a shot! Oh no, it is! Oh no, he faked it! Oh, good clearance by Buruj Academy. And this game is really coming to life right now. Ebuka on the ball. He loses the game. Oh, Kenechiku trying to play out of defense. Izuchi. Oh, good technique from this midfielder. Godwin intercept. Isaac. And he's... Oh my! A good shot by Sonny Matthew. Cliquesports is showing no relent. Relentless in the effort to score another goal. They're looking for the second goal to bury the game. And that was a very close one. Betraying to Cliquesports, against Cliquesports Academy on the left hand side. They take him at the left back. Jesus. Deva. Ekene on the ball. Olibo. Oh, too much for the goal. The goalkeeper picks it up there, Joe. Makes a quick one forward. And Cliquesports can break up again. Sonny Matthew to Isaac. Plays it forward. And it's a chance there. Oh. And Buruj attack again. He misses it, Isaac. And there's something going on here. Kenny on the ball. He passes the only ball. They're trying to break something. Oh, easily read by Godwin. The Cliquesports have the possession. Izuchi Ogbodo. Eze Steven. Good pass. Wasiu Hamza. He tries to dribble his man. He wins the throw. Deep in Buruj territory. Eze Steven. Tries to shoot. They say if you don't shoot, you don't score. Well, you have to shoot better than that to score. Deva. He loses out. Izuchi. Plays forward. And it's another chance. Sonny Matthew. Oh my God! And it's a goal! He's got a brace for himself, the striker, Clem Francis. Top player, top academy, top goal. You can see that coming. The build-up was fantastic. The players understood where each other's were, and I think Sonny Matthew was really unselfish of that. He could have scored by himself, but he played it through to his teammate Clem Francis. And Cliquesports Academy lead 2-0 at the 32nd minute. Buruj Academy had to respond, but they're losing a lot of concentration right now because he just kicked the ball out of play. And here comes Cliquesports Academy again. With Isaac, always at the right of flank and ever present. AJ Steven. And he shoots! Oh! It's another chance. Buruj Academy trying to play out of defense. They almost lost it there. It takes a lot of calm to be able to play out of defense at this level. But they have to get a goal and they have to get it fast to remain in this contest. They have good Cliquesports again. To Sonny Matthew, but lost it out. To Sharif, the center back of Buruj Academy. He goes forward to Ekene on the ball now. Tries to play. Innocent in. Innocent loses. And Cliquesports have the ball again. The ball went into touch. But replay might suggest otherwise. If it wasn't, it would have been a good chance for them, because he played a fantastic pass and Wasi was on low. Troy to Buruj Academy. Kenjiku on the ball. He's done well. Buruj have the ball. A deep ball in. He's trying to, oh my. Offside. Against Ebukar. For Buruj Academy. Now we go again. Cliquesports Academy. Izuchi on the ball. Sonny Matthew makes all the way. Tries to find Clem on the far side. But easily intercepted by Ruben. Ball is served after the number two. Osai tries to kick it out. Good pressure from the young Steven Aze. Buruj Academy at the edge now, trying to create something, and it's a chance, and they have a chance! Oh, easy for the goalkeeper, easy for the goalkeeper. He should have done better. He should have done better, the attacker, Kenneth. He should have done better. That was a goal back, if they had taken that chance. But where was the vent? Where was the defense for Cliquesports Academy? They go again. Kenneth Chico tries to play. Oh, and it's an offside. Good intent though. There's a player down for Cliquesports Academy. Sonny Matthew is down. It looks like he's in a lot of pain. The referee has called on the medical crew. The young attacker is receiving some medical attention now, Sonny Matthew. I think he's hurt his ankle while trying to run down that ball. If he's in a lot of pain, wait to see if he can continue the game. He's played well so far. The game starts. Buruj on the ball and trying to play forward. A long one forward for the fullback. Kenjiku intercepts and Cliquesports have the ball and they're playing calmly out of the fence. Eze Steven. Clem Francis. Kenjiku on the ball. It should be said that the last time an academy won the FA Cup in Lagos State was way back in the year 2001, almost 13 years ago now. So we have to see which academy is going to come up on top against the big dogs in this one. Quick play, Kenechukwu on the left side. Oh, and it's falling in the box. The referee says play on. And Buruj trying to build something out of it. And they're trying to break out. And they're going forward with their career on the ball right now. He plays a square ball to Odibo. And they have a chance here. Something is building up here. We have Odibo who makes a cross. Isaac was there to defend the Cliquesports Academy. Isaac has been impressive, I will say. Has been very impressive in this game, the young right back. 16-year-old talent to play for the national team. We'll see. Good clearance by Godwin Igwe, the Cliquesports Academy, the centre back, 6'4", really giant centre back. Cliquesports again, Reza Steven. Hamza Wasiu plays it to Sonny Matthew, has a chance. Oh my, inches off target, and the goalkeeper had a touch. That was Cliquesports. When they break forward in numbers, they break with a lot of pace, and it's difficult to contain for the Buruj Academy. Corner taking shot, Kenechiko makes a crossing, easily cleared. They still have the ball. Cliquesports Academy, Buruj hanging on right here, and the former McLaren was not that far. Kenechiko on the ball again, he tries to dribble. Clem Francis tries to play a return, but that was a lack of communication between the two. Buruj on the rise now, with Deba on the ball. Innocent. He plays him through, look at that, oh my, top side. That was a chance. It was offside. Here's Ace Steven. Hamza Basir. Oh, that was a nasty challenge by Izuchi Ogbodo, the Cliquesports player. And he might have gotten himself into the books. Yes, it is. He's gotten a yellow card for his troubles. It was late. It was wrong timing by the midfielder. Impressive so far in his distribution of the ball. But his judgment of the tackle was wrong. He ends his place in a yellow, with a yellow card and a place in the referee's book. He has to be careful. The referee setting the tone, taking authority of the game, dishing out to yellow cards in quick succession. Players will have an idea of who's in charge right now. Isaac trying to shield the ball. And it's a throw into Buruj Academy, deep in the Cliquesports half. And they have the ball from the number 10, Deba. He tries to dribble through. The referee says play on. And Cliquesports can break forward now. But they lose it. Buruj have initiated now. They have the ball. Trekene tries to dribble and takes a shot. Misses it. Another chance. Oh no. Sonny Maggi putting pressure on the goalkeeper. Buruj attack now. Long one for Odibo to chase. Just can't get past Isaac. Can't get past Isaac. Fullback for Cliquesports Academy involved in marauding into the Buruj half and causing all sorts of problems, asking all sorts of questions. And there's a change for Buruj Academy late in the first half. Innocent goes off for Talib, young midfielder, 16-year-old Talib. maybe it was an injury, I don't think, or maybe it was a tactical change. The coach of Cliquesports Academy is still on the touchline, backing out instructions to his lads. Still telling them it's not enough. Still nil, he should be sitting down. The coach of Buruj is not, it's not on the touchline. Different coach. Buruj try to attack again. They have the ball. And it's a free kick in their favor. Oh no! Free kick in the favor of Cliquesports Academy. Taken by Godwin Igwe, taking it long. Francis Clem on the ball. Pass to dribble. He has a brace today. Eze Steven. The referee says it's a foul. Francis Clem, 17-year-old striker, Cliquesports Academy, has made his name by putting two goals past the goalkeeper in the first half. He will do well with a hat-trick today. Buruj try to take the free kick from the center back, Ruben. Takes it long. Easily dealt with by Godwin Igwe, the center back. Good clearance by Babatunde Yusuf. And Buruj is still deep in the Cliquesports half, trying to get a goal, trying to create a chance. And they have a chance now. They got behind the striker. A good cross, a good chance. He flopped his lines. And a good clearance. Cliquesports attack again, and they have a chance. Clem Francis on the ball. He's on his hat-trick. He tries to turn, tries to shoot. Oh no, he misses it. And Buruj can breathe again. They're coming forward. Captain Adams for Cliquesports Academy. Kenetrico Fidelis passes inwards. He's possessed. Oh, good one by Kenny in the attack. Now Cliquesports can break now. A good cross. Oh, the keeper misses it. The keeper misses it. That was a chance. He just flopped his lines there. It's not really been called into action. Maybe a lapse of concentration. It was a great chance for Buruj Academy. Hamzat Wasiu. Offside. The next round of the FA Cup will be played Tuesday next week at the same venue, the Agege Stadium. And the winner of this tie will play the defending champion COD United at the round of 16. But whoever wins this game is going to be a very difficult stage to cross. So Buruj trying to get back in it. Right back aside with the ball. Steven Eze. Short pass and misses it. And Buruj can attack now from aside. and he wins the corner. He wins the corner off the captain Adams, the Cliquesports Academy. Corner to be taken by Deva. Good one, easily cleared. And that's the end of the half. Two goals scored by Clem Francis, and Cliquesports Academy lead by 2-0 at the Agege Stadium. Mr. Ram, the first round of the FA Cup, and the centre referee calls time on the half. And the both managers will be eager to get into the dressing room to talk to the players. I think the Cliquesports manager is just going to keep his lads going, while the Buruj manager is going to find a way to make his lads come out firing in the second half. But right here at the Agege Stadium, it's Cliquesports 2, Buruj 0. Second half has started, both sides are still unchanged. Cliquesports Academy play from left to right and Buruj from right to left. Cliquesports Academy lead by 2-0. Both goals were scored by Clem Francis, the number 9 striker. Buruj Academy needs 2 goals at least to force this game into penalties. A throw in to Cliquesports Academy. That's a foul. Clem Francis. On the midfielder Talib. And it's a Buruj free kick. Goalkeeper comes out, drops it but picks it up. It's been shaky in the first half, but he's getting more confident as the game wears on. Top goalkeeper, a lot of experience in their job. It's A. Steven, Sonny Matthew. And it's a chance for Cliquesports Academy. Hamzat Wasiu, he has a chance right now. Tries to beat his man but loses the ball. Isaac, run control, it's into tackle, throw it. Buruj FC going forward now, it's a foul. Isaac, on Talib. Free kick taken by Ruben, the captain. Easily cleared. Buruj still on the ball. They have a chance now. Ekene on the ball. It's the right back coming in here. He passes in. A good move. He's trying to shoot. Well, it was weak.
Weak shot by the forward.
Amino. Needs to go. Buruj attack on the right now. Oh. That should hurt. He's up on his feet. These lads are strong. Good skill. Buruj is telling me he's trying to build up an attack now. It's a free kick. And Buruj is turning up the momentum here. They're turning the screws on. They're trying to look for that goal. Good clearance by the Cliquesports defense. And they break forward now. Sonny Matthew takes on his man. He takes him on. Keeps going. He wins the throw-in. Sonny Matthew has been impressive this track of the Cliquesports Academy. Kenya on the ball, takes his man on, good skill. Sonny Matthew on the ball, makes the cross and it's Isaac on the far post. Try to dribble, oh no, it's a corner kick. Cliquesports Academy. They still look like they want to score. Oh, he missed it and it's a chance! Oh! The center defender got in Ligue, almost got the top goal for his team there. Narrowly misses that chance. Narrowly. You can hear the fans calling him. He's a tall center back, strong and mobile. And Buruj just hanging in there. The top goal will just kill this tie off. They cannot afford to concede another goal. Enedjiku, Steven Isaac, Abatunde Isu, Izuchi, Hamzat Wasiu. The ball bounces off the surface. It's been a little bit wet from the rains and the night before. But it's an artificial pitch, so increasing temperature will take the water out. Fair play by Isaac. It's been an infringement. Abukar is down. Teammates try to look at his leg. And the captain for Cliquesports Academy, Adams. Well, he's on his feet right now. It's difficult nowadays for referees to be objective because a lot of players in a global game now try to induce referees by tear tricks and all. It's a scourge of the game right now. Cliquesports ball forward. Clem Francis, a long ball forward. Hamzat Wasiu. He's got a chance. He runs the goalkeeper. He's still there. He tries to pass it now. That was a golden chance. You could see the captain, Ruben, scolding his left fullback, Yusuf. In Cliquesports Academy, I've had chances to bury this game. It should be 3-4-5 right now. Isaac on the corner. Oh, and Godu Nigo is there again, trying to use his height. And Buruj can breathe again. And Leclerc. That's a foul. A foul, and Buruj started quickly. The time is ticking. Cliquesports, Pabsad was you chasing down. Free kick to Cliquesports Academy. You can see they're still trying to get a third goal. And they're a very attacking side. And are not contented with those two goals we've scored. Free kick, Isaac takes it long. Oh, another free header in the box by Sonny Matthew, and he missed it. How on earth did he miss that goal? Can't hold the ball right now, Buruj Academy. They're just playing long balls in, and the Cliquesports defense are taking it back. This is not the way to score. But let's see how they play. Cliquesports play again. Can Echiku on the ball? Two ball for the Clem Francis. Sloppy play from the striker. Sloppy play. Oh, high boot from Maze Steven. It was unintentional. You can see he's trying to apologize to the player. And the referee knows that. Oh, that's good spirit of sportsmanship. It was just an accident. So innocent, the young lad. Long cross team. Buruj are picking up now. Aminu. Odibo. Try to flick it on. Oh, Isaac. Good skill. Isaac again. Impressive, that young man. Sonny Matthew. He plays it forward for Francis Clam. Sonny Matthew! Shoots. Oh, and he flops his lines. Nzuchi turns, keeps possession, plays forward. Clem Francis, oh, and they're building up again. And that's Kenechi Kufidelis on the ball. Back to Nzuchi Ogbodo. Tries to play him on Babatunde. And it's cleared by Buruj Academy. And he's back in possession with Cliquesports. Here they come again with the ball. Isaac. Tries to find Sonny Matthew. He does. He's stretching the Buruj defense left and right. And it's been tough on those defenders right now. You see players for Cliquesports Academy warming up. Change might be in the offing right now. Godwin Igwe on the ball. Babatunde Yusuf, the number 4. Nzuchi. Adam, the captain. Eze Steven. Kenechiku on the attack. He was under pressure. And it's a corner kick. The first corner kick is not going to be taken by Isaac, taken by the Clem striker. And Godwin gets a header. Sonny Magic tries to flicks it on, and it's a good clearance. Oh, good skill from Kenechi. Good skill. Oh, that was a high boot. And that was a yellow card for number 2 for Buruj Academy, Osai. It's been booked for that high boot. You see Francis Clem trying to take up some fluid from the physio. Players are eager to get the game going. Buruj Academy has no response. It's still the first round of the FA Cup round of 16 at the Agege Stadium between Cliquesports Academy and Buruj Academy, and the score remains 2-0 in favour of Cliquesports. Buruj is yet to score. We have about 15 minutes to the end of the game. And here goes Buruj Academy on the ball now from the attacker Ekene. He passes Odibo, and this is something coming here. He shapes the shoe. And it's a chance! Oh! Eze Steven, calm, and Cliquesports play out of defense again. Sonny Matthew on the charge, down the other end. He beats his man, he goes in. Sonny Matthew, he passes square. Oh! He couldn't find his man in the box. And he forced Rams out Yusuf. Oh! And it's a goal! Can you believe it? 3-0 Cliquesports Academy, and it's all over for Buruj here. The journey in the FA Cup has started and ended on the same day. Hamzat will see you as open his account in the FA Cup 2014 at the Agege Stadium with a well-taken strike from inside the box. Buruj are shaping up to make a change now. To see how they can remedy the situation. Cliquesports too are shaping up to make a change. We'll see how the coaches think tactically, how to alter the formation. It's 3-0 in favor of Cliquesports Academy. Oh, the coach of Cliquesports finally sat down. Yusuf, Nzuchi, Eze Steven, Clem, Kenechiku, Yusuf, long one forward, for Hamza, the goal scorer. He's in the box again. Another chance. Across. Oh! Clarence by the Buruj Academy. Now Izuchi on the ball. He shapes it in. He turns it, man. Oh, it's a skill. And it's a penalty. It's a penalty. How on earth did he not get that? That is a controversial decision by the referee. We have to see it back on replay to see if he had it correctly. That looked like a penalty from first watch. Izuchi is still down in the box. Top player by Cliquesports Academy. They've been impressive from the beginning. You could see their intent from the goal. They look more likely to win the game from the first minute. But that looked like a penalty. There are changes to be made now. Kolaole is coming up for the two-goal hero, Clem Francis. While Ekene is going out and coming in. Ekene and Aminu have been changed for Buruj Academy. They took out two strikers and they're bringing on two strikers. Well, the coach knows what he's saying, but I don't. It's a funny one. Well, Cliquesports Academy have taken out the striker and put on the more holding midfielder. Buruj Academy have brought on Silvanus and Bakari for Aminu and Ekene. Let's see what the young duo can bring out. 3 goals in 10 minutes. It's going to be a miracle. Izuchi. Eze Steven. Hamza Basiu. Third goal scorer. Troy. Buruj Academy. Sonny Mappy. Izuchi Obodo. Buruj coming up in forwards now. Ebuka on the ball. And it's a free kick. Free kick for Buruj Academy to be taken by the centre back Ruben, the captain. Another change for Cliquesports Academy as they're taking out Eze Steven, the 50-year-old, to stand an ovation by the fans on the near side. He's had a wonderful performance for a 15-year-old. Coming in will be Prince for his debut in the FA Cup. An ambitious free kick, and it amounted to nothing. The Cliquesports Academy can do it again. Cliquesports Academy. Izuchi try to play cross field. Buruj attack now. And they have a chance. Oh, close to a corner by Gordon Igwe. Corner for Buruj now. They have a chance and oh my, good save by Dejo, the goalkeeper. And a quick service one now, steps forward. Cliquesports be trying to break, but it didn't come to effect. Buruj have the ball, he's in lost, comes out, what's you. Mr. Crockett to call out the new substitute. And this is it. Mr. Troy and Evo Cliquesports. Easy ball for the goalkeeper. Great ball again. Foul. We will take it quickly. The number 4, Mukhain, is probing deeper now. He's moving better with the ball. The left back was trying to lose his possession. The police ball can break it now. Pull out the ball. Try to make a pocket run. Couldn't get it with some more. I would say the new substitutes for Buruj Academy have had a little effect. They have a little effect in the fact that they've not passing down their goal scoring since they've come on. It's almost 5 minutes now. The game is winding up to an end. And it's a goal kick. Cliquesports with another chance. Oh no. Sonny Matthew overran that. I think he hit it too much. Buruj playing forward now. Ebukar to Talib. Try to switch it. And Izuchi on the ball now. He picks out his man. Izuchi Obodo. Going by himself. Falls over. Buruj can break now. Ebuka on the ball. Silvanus. Referee says play on. Kola. Izuchi Obodo. Plays it for Isaac. But Silvanus, the striker, comes back and does a good job defensively. I think it looks like he's in a lot of pain. Still clutching his face. Isaac will be fine, apparently. We're in the last few minutes of the game. If Buruj is going to score, they have to score now. It's football. Nothing is impossible. But they need to score, and they need to score fast. Isaac is signifying that he wants to get back on the pitch of play. Buruj have lost the ball now. Cliquesports on the ball, Babatunde Yusuf. Tries to fill in Kola on the near side. But no, Buruj can break now. Moving forward. Yusuf on the ball now. We've seen lots on the ball in the last few minutes. Izuchi. Kenejuku on the ball now, the fullback. Trap the pass. During the foul incident, Cliquesports made the final change of bringing on Afiz for the striker, Tony Matthew. Cliquesports are defending now as Buruj try to attack. And it's a goal kick. Long ball forward for Buruj now. They don't have bodies forward. Kenna, Prince, Yusuf, Prince forward. He's throwing. Cliquesports Academy has never exited the FA Cup in the first round, so history suggested they were going to win this, and they've gone on to do it. It's going to take a miracle now for them to lose this game, because Buruj Academy are not showing any signs of wanting to score, and Cliquesports Academy can look forward to playing COD United in the next round, and bookmakers are going to be betting their odds against Cliquesports Academy, because COD are the defending champions and a very, very solid team with a lot of experience. Stadium is fairly quiet. The fans of Buruj Academy are looking in disbelief as the team has been short of ideas. Another free kick to Cliquesports Academy at the edge of the area. Be taken. You see how three players on the ball, Izuchi, Wasu, and Kola, all shipping up on who wants to take it. I think it's Izuchi that's going to strike this. He's a dead ball specialist. Oh, on the side netting, it was close. It was close. It could have been four. Izuchi Ogbodo has had a wonderful game. He's passed well, he's moved well. He's fed his strikers. He's had a good game. Kenechiku and Isaac, both the fullbacks, have been truly exceptional. You can see him calling for the ball on the far end. He's always wanted the ball, Isaac. Exchange of passes now by the Cliquesports player. Now they're toying with the Buruj attack. They're toying with them. And you see an attack now. He's calling on the ball. Chasing now. One-on-one with the attacker. He tries to dribble. The defender does well, but it's a throwing for Buruj Academy. Another join. Buruj are coming forward now. Dispossessed. That was a very, very nasty challenge on Babatunde Yusuf by Talib